our budget committee as well as Orca Media. Hello, Orca Media.
Hello.
Are there any amendments to the agenda? Okay. Alrighty, well, it's 5:02. Should we head straight into the budget workshop?
Yeah.
Alrighty, presentation of office administration budget. So, is that you?
Well, it's a combination. We basically, in collaboration with Sarah, we have pretty much tried to level fund where we could. We went down where we could. I want to just say that anything with a question mark, which I may have looked like I missed a couple here, but the health insurance is like basically all the insurances are still up in the air.
Still
we're still waiting for final numbers.
Do you think they're pretty close on those?
They're fairly close, I think. I level funded some of them that I didn't know, so depending on the percentage increase they come across with. And the wages, I have stuck a 2% in for wage across the board. We haven't even discussed wages yet.
Right.
So,
right.
But I just put that in so there would be a number there. So, of course, all your taxes for wages and everything like that will coincide with whatever number that you come up with.
Excuse me, I'm just gonna, do you mind if I turn this off? Because we're just wasting money. It's 15 minutes, it's gone by. And she,
You mean, so in other words, if she tries to call in, she won't be able to get us?
She'll have to call in the regular one. I'm sorry, Deborah.
That's okay, no problem. So that's basically throughout every category, just not the administration part of it, as far as insurances and wages. So I am still, again, wherever I was missing information from a department, I have just gone and level funded it. I just barely got one in there, so that might have taken care of a lot of the holes.
Okay.
So whatever you have questions on, we'll try to answer.
So Welch Park is that new line that we had talked about, right? Because we didn't.
Welch Park is our portion of what we pay for down there.
But we didn't have it as a separate line, did we, this year?
Yes, it was in there for 2000. No, there was no budget for 2018, you're right.
Yeah, okay.
And then we ended up having the expense, which was unordinary to have that kind of expense. But I think last year, for this current year, we had plugged in $1,000. So I plugged in $1,000 for next year, too. But we did end up spending in FY18 the $2,453.
Question. What's going on with the computer maintenance?
That was, we ended up buying new computers.
Got it.
And
hello?
Which is something that I wanted to discuss as well.
Hello?
Do you have to answer it on the other phone or no?
No, I can answer it right here.
Can?
I thought it was Mary, but we'll see. Okay.
Which I think our regular monthly maintenance now on the computers is up over $6,000 a month. I mean,
$600
a month.
Oh, okay. Way to make 600 sound good.
Yeah.
So that's the 812.
Yeah.
8,112.
Yeah. Buy some big ones.
600, yeah.
So I think that's something you really should take a look at.
And that includes that we added back in, didn't we, the
yeah, because we
the extra time that was included.
We didn't buy any extra or just ongoing hours because we wanted to see how it went. And, you know, so we were paying the high rate as opposed to a discounted rate. Mm. And, you know, Peter and I are supposed to get together with Ruben again here. Like 6 months after the last meeting, too, and he was going to come with data. to look at where we actually stood and how much was, you know, we had for carryover hours and stuff. So
I wonder if there's any comparison with some of the other smaller towns. Like, what are they doing for computers, and is it costing them? Do we know?
I don't know.
How many computers are there?
I mean, there's a whole network. We essentially rebuilt the whole network, which was the main issue, and backup.
Right.
Was what we were really concerned about. Was one, we don't want to get hacked,
right,
and we don't want to have a crash of all of our financial and land records and all that stuff,
right,
and try to replace
that'd
it.
That'd be
all,
devastating.
So, yeah.
Have all the little glitches been?
It seems like it's been quite a bit better, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, from a night and day.
Yeah,
it has.
It's weird because it's too bad that we didn't get the pack in the beginning. Then
you know, I don't think it would have mattered because whenever
yeah,
you do a rebuild like that, there's always stuff that you're gonna have to work out.
But it's
at least
been going smooth.
Yeah.
But we've held off doing the email transition.
Yeah.
Because I just didn't want to have any more problems.
Yeah. That's a huge thing.
So
yeah,
is the $600 a month based on the past, or is it based on just you
that's
moving forward?
That's our monthly rate. We pay $600 and some dollars a month.
Yeah.
So that 62% increase is truly the increase over what we budgeted last year, because we didn't have that type of contract in place.
Right.
How many computers are we talking about?
We've got
four. Plus the server?
And Paul.
And Paul.
Three.
Oh, this.
Yeah, this one.
Per month, that number of computers.
It's really the network, the firewall,
right,
and the server, and the backup is really the you know, the main cost.
Are you paying for cloud storage?
Yes.
Through who?
Through our provider. RB Technologies runs its own cloud service.
So that's for all town records?
Yeah, I think so. Is everything in that now?
Well, we have two clouds. We've got the cloud for land records, which is
right,
ACS. So that's owned by now Continuum. Used to be Xerox. Then we've got the system back there. If you go down the hallway, you can see that. And then I think we're storing stuff at RB Technology. So
right,
we have, and then NEMRIC, which is our municipal software program, backs up. So we've got multiple. Hopefully, should anything happen, we've got multiple.
Yeah.
That's a good plan.
NEMRIC backs up
the payroll
every day, or every
it should back up
every
day. Every
day, right.
Yeah.
So NEMRIC backs up every day to their cloud, and that's part of the agreement with them on the software. And then what we wanted was a secondary backup. So when we put together the plan with RB Technologies, we're backing that up, everything, all files, email, and backing up NEMRIC again.
Nice.
So we have a redundant backup. Yeah.
That's good.
And everything's
good.
Everything's off site, so
nice,
which is the way it ought to be.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. And we don't have to mess around with tape drives and stuff like the old days.
Taking home a hard drive.
Yeah, right, that's right. That's right. You had an external hard to carry around. So yeah, it is. I mean, I think it is pricey for
yeah,
a small.
A lot for it,
but I think the concerns that we were starting to have was, you know, just kind of like, do we really want to be the select board that has our financial system crash? No.
No, we don't.
Exactly.
A couple of things which, under town property maintenance, the last year we spent $2,081. That was for painting and stuff. So what we normally do is we take it out of the discretionary fund because we never budget anything in there. So I don't know if you want to start budgeting anything in that, because when it gets, we always use discretionary money, but then it gets
right,
posted to the proper account for accounting purposes.
Yeah.
So far we have $930 in that, and that is, I think I stuck the lawn mowing.
Yeah, where are we on that one?
At the top under general government.
Okay.
Because,
under, where is it?
Town property maintenance.
Okay, yes.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that's something you want to consider putting a number in there for, rather than continue to do the use discretionary.
And that was, we painted a little bit of town hall, and we painted
the roof.
Oh, we did the roof on the.
And then this year you're doing some windows or lighting upstairs, right?
We're doing lighting downstairs. We've already done the lighting upstairs,
okay.
But also I think Peter likes to do like one side of town hall a summer.
Every.
But don't we have a building fund? Isn't it? Can we do it out of that?
Well, it's all where, what happens is if you want it to come out of there, then it should be noted as it. They always sit here and say, take it out of the discretionary fund.
Right.
So, I mean, and the discretionary fund is just an extra, really, just an extra number in the budget for whatever pops up.
You know, I think we kind of have this ongoing maintenance thing that we're doing that we ought to actually
budget for it.
It's planned work. You know, it gives us an idea how much money we're spending on that. We can look at it over time rather than, you know, then hoping we don't need the discretionary fund for something that really turns out to be an emergency. So, personally, I'd rather see us.
I think so.
Yeah.
So
is there any line like that now for a building fund?
I'm sorry.
Is there any line now for a building fund?
We did put in, I think, some sort. Did we put one in? I think we might have. Good question.
There's building repairs under town hall.
Oh, there is.
So the town hall is.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Right,
is separate.
Separate from that.
Yeah.
For this, so the, I guess the.
But that's not a fund. That's just.
That's
a repair.
Just a repair fund, and that's strictly for this building, like painting the fire department. That old building didn't come under. I guess this building where Patty posted it, because we did look up what was under there, and she said it was painting up the building over here.
Well, you do have a building fund.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's building maintenance in the fire department, too.
Yeah.
There's,
that's town garage building fund.
Yeah.
Hmm. Seems like you're underfunded for long-term maintenance of this.
Yeah.
Considering the
condition. I think we need to also talk about the conversation that we've been having about, you know, another changing the town clerk office.
Building.
And so are we, if we want to present that to the voters, it would be nice to have a little slush fund to say we're putting this towards it. And I think we should take it seriously and not just keep talking about it. Because eventually it's going to sort of be necessary, and we don't want to present, have nothing saved for it.
And where are we with the elevator? We didn't do any repair.
So the elevator is okay. The elevator has a very tricky switch in it that, with all due respect, Peter was fooling with, and
okay.
We didn't stop. But the, I think, and I may be wrong on this, that if you guys wanted to create a fund, you've got to go to the voters and create a fund.
Right.
To create a fund. So it looks like we have a, I might be wrong on this, but it looks like we have a garage building fund, but it doesn't look like we have a designated building fund.
No, we don't.
So you could might want to consider putting that on the warrant.
Yeah. Right, and then not fund, you know, this. Just
so we can have that as a separate conversation when we talk about special articles.
Yeah.
Is there a place where there's a list of all the funds that exist for the town?
I don't think it's in the
budget report, but yes, there is several different funds that can only be used for those purposes.
What there are and aren't.
We can, they're available. We can get them. I can get you.
I can mail them to you next week if you want.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, we don't. They don't go in the budget status kind of reports because they're really inactive. The money, you know, there's appropriation.
Once they're there.
Yeah, until something has to be taken.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
So now what are we asking? We're talking specifically now about.
Well, I was just mentioning, you know, that might be
the
something
the town property
you want.
Maintenance.
Yeah.
Right.
So anything like that.
And I'm sorry, you came up with that 930, that was based
That's
on...
That's a number that, and I'm going to move that, actually. It was something that Mitch just gave me before he left a few minutes ago, and that's for lawn mowing for the town hall and for the property down on Three Mile Bridge Road. So, but I'm gonna move that into, I think, actually, I don't know. The town, the mowing here could probably go in under the grounds for the town hall, but I think the other needs to stay under for town property, because it's just.
It doesn't have it under his, remember how Mitch has his own?
Well, he has his own, but that's recreation, it's not town.
So that's not the mowing.
So this town property maintenance?
God.
Doesn't that cover the whole town, everything? Why does all of the departments have a separate fund then?
For town property? For.
Yeah.
Well, there's this, but, well, we have one for grounds, it's not maintenance, it's like town hall has a budget. It's something you guys created, you wanted everything associated with that.
With there, yeah.
This is just a general one that doesn't have its own entity. Like the property down on Three Mile Bridge Road that has to be mowed, and it doesn't fall under the rec department.
Oh, that was gonna be my question, that doesn't fall under the.
It doesn't fall under, because it's not part of the rec department.
So we're saying that should fall under general government?
General.
Right, because.
Okay, alright.
Yeah.
And that's where it.
Yep.
Yep, okay. And that's where you got the 930, alright.
Yeah.
We have this guy, Andy Plant, who does the plantings around here. Andy Plant. That's not part of the rec thing.
He's a good guy.
He is a good guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see, moving down, a little bit, trying to see where there was big changes. Elections, there's not as many elections, so that kinda went down, or we don't have to hold as many for that year, so we went down on that. Let's.
And that, is that expense just paying the $50 that people make, or what is that?
No, it's the advertising, it's,
Right, yeah, you're, so, in the 2019-2020 budget, which we're gonna pay for, is the formatting of, I think we're gonna pay for it, I think we get some money from the state, formatting for the presidential primary.
Okay.
So that's one election, and then the formatting for the town, for town meeting as well, because all the town and school meetings.
Where do the salaries come from, just the little, you know, money that people make, collect, you know?
That gets budgeted into, elections, that comes out of that money.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you do about the fact that, you know, the health officer, the animal control officer never put in for their?
They don't put it in, so it just, you know, it's an unspent money. But I think.
But we do have the obligation.
We have it, I think it's wise to keep it in there, I'm only putting in for 1 hour a week.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, it's peanuts.
Eric is not asking for money?
He just doesn't submit a bill.
Yeah. But I do think you should have a placeholder just in case, so that gives you 52 hours of their time.
Does it make sense for us to, I mean, maybe we don't wanna do this, but the way that we get paid for the select board, we're just given a stipend to give them a stipend? At the same time, we get our stipend, so that they don't have to submit a bill?
I'd rather see them submit a bill, I mean, they could end up with a bunch of hours.
Right.
They haven't been billing, but.
Right.
I'd rather see them.
I mean, so we will pay them more than what we have budgeted if they presented us with hours.
Yes.
And they fall more under our employee category than we do as elected.
Right.
Right, cause you would have to pay payroll taxes on them and all of that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, are we going into this other page talking about this stuff?
You can go wherever, yeah, I just, I mean, I was kinda seeing if somebody, I kinda gave you the overall summary on things. Emergency management, as you know, under public safety, that's something you guys really should go back and, I know it's a new line item, but.
Remember how I tried to save the money for it every year? That was my goal, was to save money for it so that we'd have it, and then, I don't.
How did you do?
Well, I think that the money was never put into a fund. It was just budgeted and never used. So
and that's
never...
what happens. Unless it's a fund is created, it has to go back into the fund, general budget.
I just think that given the given what we've had to deal with just like the last weather event that we had, that we need to be a little bit more cognizant of like what's going on around us in town to make sure that like there aren't people who are, you know, dying in their homes that we don't know about, and like the emergency management, you know, I think his budget was realistic in terms of what he presented to us, and we're going to be probably relying on it more and more as time goes on emergency management services. I just say we bite the bullet on that. I don't think it's asking a lot, and if we find that it's something that we're really not using, then we can revisit it. But there were a few things that looked like maybe we wouldn't use the money for, but I would imagine we'd use a couple $1,000.
Yeah. That's not much money in there anyway.
Right. No, it's not a lot. It's not a big, it just looks big on the budget.
It looks big on the budget, but.
Yeah.
You could go 2 years and not need it.
Right.
And you slam.
And use five times that much.
Yeah. Right.
In an heartbeat.
Right.
Yeah.
Did worker comp rates drop?
Well, that's where I'm trying to get a clarification on it. That's why there's question marks all over the place on
they
that.
Get it from our insurance company.
Yeah, they have gone down, but we're like really off on some of these numbers with wages and workers' comp and all. And I have to talk to Patty and find out, you know, because I think, first of all, I think some numbers are getting posted to a different category to where we budgeted it.
Oh.
And, you know, like, and then, for instance, Sarah is a good example of that, because she's in general government as your assistant, mm-hmm. and then she's in administration as a clerk.
Right.
I think a lot of the discrepancy there is it's going to one and not the other, or not being split accordingly. So I need to talk to Patty on that.
Yeah.
But I'm also trying to, I'm waiting for some rates from our insurance company. So that's why I hope to get that all finalized. So kind of disregard wages and workers' comp. And I know that's what's making these numbers
jump around.
Yeah. Do you think our power will go down in the town hall once we change our lights? What was up with the 15% increase in the electricity for the town hall?
I upped it up because if you look at the budget for 2018, we budgeted, we spent $2,600. So I upped it to $2,600. If we spent that in 18, I can only imagine it'll be that in 20.
But I wonder, are these new lights supposed to help with power, or are they just supposed to look better?
No, they're supposed to help.
They're switching your IDs. Yeah.
And we could probably, if you want to go back to level funding it, that's fine. You know, I just did because we were over in 18.
No, that makes sense. Is there something coming in? Is that Peter? Let's
Hi.
Hi, Ruth. How are you?
Show off today.
Hi, Ruth. Would you guys mind sharing one of these with her?
It's kind of like the county tax and, you know.
I just need one before I go home.
You've got to live with them.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Our debt service did go down. We did on some stuff, so that helps.
What does it say on the agenda? It talks about the VLCT dues. Where's that?
Oh, I just I think I was deciding whether to put it under correspondence or.
Oh, okay.
It's just what the dues are. I think you put them in, didn't you?
Yeah.
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 No big deal.
So.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I think she was just going to say they use a per capita rate,
right.
So it was just correspondence, that's what it was going to be.
Is there anything about the highway department, Steve, that you perhaps fine-tuning highway department request?
Did I find what?
No, it says perhaps fine-tuning highway department request. Was there anything in the highway department that you wanted to fine-tune?
No.
Salt's taking a pretty good job, huh?
Yeah.
Is that because you're salting the shady rill more? Is that what it was?
Well, I don't know how much salt he used, but I mean, we're trying to use this much.
Yeah. And chloride in the summer?
Pardon?
Chloride use in the summer?
And chloride use
what,
in the
what's,
summer.
What's the main use? What do you use that for?
For the chloride?
Yeah.
Keep the dust down. With chloride to dirt roads.
Oh, no. I bet you I could watch that being done.
Not
if
just
I
water.
you probably have watched it.
Right by your house. You must do it after I open the refrigerator for the heavy topper.
That could be.
Okay.
Yeah, we did have one other line item that Dorinda added was a stormwater discharge fee. It should be an ongoing thing. That's why you threw me off because you said wastewater, and that's why I was.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wastewater, stormwater, it's all the same.
It's all the same.
Wow. Is that to the state we pay that?
Yes.
Is that,
yeah. 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 Yeah.
Is that every year? Stormwater district.
Where is that?
I don't know.
It's going to get worse.
Yeah,
it's not going to get better.
I know we talked about this, but I can't recall what we talked about in terms of budgeting for the. Elm trees? Is it the elm tree?
Yeah.
The removal of the elm tree?
The ashes.
The ashes. Dutch elm disease.
Yeah, that was
a long time ago.
But he spoke here. He said it was premature to do that.
Okay, so not for 2020. All right.
Under recreation, I don't know if you've gotten down there yet, but Mitch is dropping the portalette rental from 2 down to 1.
Okay.
So,
nice.
Saved $600 there.
I saw something about that learn to swim. That's
That's on the phone now.
Right, and I wonder if that's something that, if it's something that. That's an addition, right? That's not...
No, that's in the budget. We have $500 in Learn to Swim.
Right, well, but this is later
this is for
down.
Winter.
Oh, that
I was asking about the Waterbury program.
So I wonder if we should make it $750. If that's something that's going to become a regular thing.
Mitch said it was just that Waterbury didn't have enough kids to sign up, and so talked to him and said, well, if you want to get some Middlesex kids for this winter swim program, you can do this, and... The kids in Waterbury pay $75. The full fee is $100. And what Mitch is going to ask for in this $250 line item is whether or not 10 kids could be funded that $25 so they pay the same. They pay the discounted rate that the Waterbury kids pay. Get it?
Yeah.
I don't know how you guys want to deal with that, but
right.
That's what that's about.
But I just wonder if that's something that becomes successful, it will become... an expectation that there's this winter learn to swim as well. No, I just, you know, do we want to do it once and never do it again? Or should we put it in
where
the budget?
Where do they swim?
First in fitness.
Really?
Yeah.
Which is very unusual because they can't do the summer program up at First in Fitness because they don't have the personnel to do it. So
is that right?
Yeah. That's why it went to the Montpelier pool. It's because they couldn't handle it up there. That's why.
We provide our own lifeguard at First in Fitness. School. First in Fitness doesn't often have lifeguards available.
Right, and that was the problem with, so I'm surprised that that program is even in place because they can't accommodate us.
All right, so let's not worry about it then.
It's a different item anyway.
Yeah. Well, I just meant to put it in for next year's budget if that's the case. But let's not. Okay, so Shady Mill Park is still in out of state. Bandstand mowing, what happened to that?
Is that part of your...
Where's the bandstand mowing?
He now, it's all under the town BOR. I think it all gets, they don't bill separately. I think it's all under...
Oh, the line up above.
Okay. Yeah, I think before it used to be a separate bill. Mm-hmm. I almost think you had somebody...
Oh, BOR, you. Okay, yeah.
So I think it's all under one now.
Okay.
Because he only gave me one mowing thing.
Okay.
But to the point there, it's, he gave me the same thing, but 2018 came in at quite a bit higher. So I guess I'm going to have to ask him. Because he only gave me a budget number of 3,520 last year and this year. But yet it came in at 6,000 for 2018. Yeah. So I'll go back and research those bills and ask what the difference is there.
Alrighty, so to keep on the agenda, do we have any other questions about this?
And this will, now that I've got most every budget in here other than fine-tuning insurances and such, I think we should schedule like time to talk about at the next meeting or something about wages.
Yeah.
Then we can...
Have we met with everyone else?
Yeah.
That has presented? Okay.
So wage increases aren't plugged into this.
Right.
Well, there's, some are. I put 2% in there for all everybody, but the numbers are not coming out in some cases because there was a part after we had approved the budget last year, we made some changes to wages. So it is going to make the numbers look a little bit different, but...
So is it realistic that we're going to come in under the last year's budget?
But that's, no, that's number's very off right there. Yeah.
That would be nice, but wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it be nice?
I don't have to.
Really good.
Yeah. Well, that's why I said don't believe everything you're reading here. It was more or less because we hadn't given you anything on paper yet, and but I just got two departments at, 4:30, I was just given the budget from two departments, so.
Alrighty. Are we all set? Okay. Our regular meeting comes to order. Are you guys going to now head out, budget committee?
Yeah, at least one will come.
Thanks. I don't know, what are we doing, guys? We can't meet. We haven't worn a meeting, so.
Okay.
No. We're just here.
Well, you are welcome to stay.
Yeah.
Keep it to stay because I wanted to bring up something under other business.
Oh, okay. Perfect. All right, so we begin our regular meeting at 5:36. So we are going to review and possibly approve fiscal year 18 audit performed by Batchelder and Associates. Action possible. And we got that emailed to us.
Yeah, emailed it also here. A couple of copies.
Okay.
You guys
want
to look through?
I'll share one with
I
someone.
I just didn't
want to. Did you all kind of?
Yeah,
I gave Larry one.
I saw your
I looked at him. I sort of skimmed it.
It.
I got a lot to read.
I did.
It was like.
Okay. So, Dorinda, what did you think about the auditor's report? Was there anything that stood out to you that?
Overall, she said all of our books were in order.
Okay, right, good.
So. There was nothing that I could see that jumped out as a problem. The good thing is, I mean, they do go through and do a pretty thorough job as far as taking samplings of everything. And
was this our second year with them?
It's our second year with them. And And also, well, which is back to where she went up another $200 this year to do the budget. I don't know if that'll happen again, but it's definitely every year going up. So,
okay.
Like everything else.
Yeah.
But I didn't see anything in here. It's pretty dry reading.
Yeah. Did Peter make any comment, Sarah?
Peter did not make any comment except to say that he was reading through it. So. And is this something that we have to approve?
It's something you're going to have to approve.
Okay, Seth, do we want to wait until Peter has looked at it before we do that? Is there any reason why we have to approve it right now?
No, you just have to approve it before you get the warning of it.
Right, and then she'll make up, like, I have to get back to her. This is only a draft.
Okay, yeah.
Until you approve it, and then she'll send the finals.
What do you guys think?
I'd like to know what Peter thought.
Yeah, I think so, too.
I mean, I don't think he's going to see anything different than we are, but there's nothing that stands out in the report at all. But it's not fun reading.
Right,
no, it's not.
I mean, I just think given with the fact that Mary and Peter are not here, that it would probably be a good idea for us to hold off, pass over it till next time. Great.
All right, I put it on for the next meeting as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Well, now we're ahead of schedule. 5:45, Treasurer's Report, General Financial Review, Action Unlikely.
Basically, I've been concentrating on the budget, so there's really nothing new to report.
All right. Anyone have questions or anything? Okay. So, considering whether the town should try to renew the current town plan as stopgap while it is being revised for later in 2019 or 2020 townwide vote. No action. So, I had a question about this because we have, now you're leaving. Have you left yet? Yes, you have.
I'm gone.
You're gone. Okay. Because the town plan, as it is right now,
has expired.
Right. And then the zoning regs are also up for, renewal.
They haven't expired.
Yeah, they haven't expired, but weren't we counting on the town
plan? We're talking about the town plan, not the zoning regs.
No, I know. But wasn't it something where we couldn't change something before we changed the town plan?
You couldn't change the zoning regs.
Yeah, we couldn't change the zoning regs. So I'm wondering where the zoning regs are in. They're just waiting for the town plan.
So I just want to update this because since the last time Mitch asked me to put this on.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Okay. The town ship has sailed. You can no longer pass renew an old plan because that plan's expired. So that's an option. So I guess now the question that the Mitch and everybody wanted from the feedback from the select board was, is it worth trying to rush through a new town plan? And I don't think physically that's possible with all the warnings and everything else like that. Mm-hmm. So now, this question becomes kind of like a moot point now, since you can't. Now we're looking at either a special election in 2019, or else waiting until 2020. But anyway,
to present a town plan to the town,
correct?
That's going to be whatever,
and that's the planning
commission
is going to be working on.
That's
on coming up with your.
So, but we can't renew the current town plan.
We cannot.
So the question is, we have to have a town plan.
And we have the town plan.
No, I know, but one that's not expired.
That's what we're working on.
I know, but so I'm saying, but it's okay for us to have an expired town plan.
I don't think we have a choice right now.
Right. Until 2020. Like, it's okay for that to happen, yes?
It's the same question. What's the danger of
that? Right, yeah, I don't know.
The danger, according to Mitch, is that we will not be eligible for certain grants.
That's
right.
I mean, it was kind of like a chicken and egg situation. We were going to get a grant to help us do the town plan, right? But we can't get that grant because we haven't done the new town plan.
Right.
So,
that grant was that we went after was not particularly
right.
to redo the town plan, but to do a transportation study.
That would have been part of the town plan meeting.
That would have been part of the town.
Right, yeah, so it is a little bit.
I just wanted to clarify.
Solar stuff too, like, can't someone like throw up like windmill somewhere if we don't have a town plan that?
No.
No, the zoning regs are still in effect.
That's zoning regs.
Yeah.
It's that we can't change the zoning regs without it agreeing with the town plan.
It all comes from the planning commission. I mean, the select board can't jump ahead.
Right. So, all right.
So when do the zoning regs expire?
They don't.
I don't think they do, but it said if people, if you wanna make changes to them, they can't.
Can't be done.
It can't be done if they don't coincide, if they don't agree with what the town plan says. So I think that there were some changes that people wanted to make in the zoning regs that they couldn't make because it didn't agree with what the town planned. So then the idea was, okay, we'll change the town plan so that you can then adjust some of these zoning regs. So just nothing.
We had to redo the town plan anyway.
Right, exactly, yeah, but, okay, so we just, yeah.
Now we're just waiting for timeline from the planning commission.
Oh, okay. I was gonna ask you, you know, before you got off, if you had any idea
what
that timeline might look like.
Yeah, I think that the current planning commission would like to think there would be something in place by late summer. I don't think it's possible.
Okay.
But.
Did you get any bites on, I saw in the paper that you were advertising a position for the planning, zero bites?
How often do they meet?
Oh, excellent.
He's interested.
Be careful.
No.
You're appointed.
They meet one
brief Wednesday.
One Wednesday a month.
Yeah, exactly.
And so if you were interested, you could submit a letter and then we could put you on the agenda for the 18th. You can be the stopgap, but then you'd have to run again, but you only need 15 signatures.
Right. I don't know if I have time, I'm just curious.
Curiosity, yeah, it's a good thing.
Okay, good.
All right, so are we done with that?
Just appointed he's not here. Okay, we need more young people.
Wow, we're doing really well. It's 5:45.
So meanwhile, is it, building for that subdivision, all of that still gets approved as.
Yes.
As normal.
I'll make sure we do.
Yeah.
Yes.
For whatever the, yeah, whatever the zoning regs are, yeah.
You just can't change the zoning regs without having the town.
Right.
It sounds like that's the one to catch.
Okay, so I guess we're moving to other business. Do we have enough people that were present at the meeting to approve it? Okay. So we're gonna approve the select board minutes. Thanks for coming. Budget.
I'll move that we approve the minutes of November 13th.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? There's no one to oppose. All right, they have been approved. The November 13th minutes. Replacing 10 fluorescent lights in the town clerk's office with LEDs for $1,500 with a $300 rebate. Anyone have discussion about this? Sarah, would you like to talk about this?
Peter asked for this to happen.
Yep.
He's not here, but that's what he wanted.
Okay. It's these lights here because
well,
the upstairs ones were replaced. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well,
we generally think that's a good idea, right?
We generally think that's a good idea.
It and it's going to have a nicer color?
They'll have a nicer color. They'll last longer, more energy efficient.
Okay.
It's the energy efficient.
Yeah.
I
mean, perfect.
I replaced 10 of them in my barn at a pretty healthy price.
Did you get a rebate?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe you can help me fill it out because I'm having trouble with the form.
I'll move approval on this.
Okay.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. So we have approved the new lights at $1,500 with a $300 rebate. Is that something that you would do, take care of that $300 rebate for us? Okay. Allocating $250 for a winter learn to swim program in conjunction with Waterbury Rec, action likely. So could you explain again what Mitch said?
Right, so the Waterbury Recreation Department has a learn to swim program and that's run in the winter at First and Fitness. And they have a certain number of kids they can have and they came up short. So they asked if Middlesex kids, or Mitch maybe, you know, could join. But. Mm-hmm. So Mitch would like $225 per kid allocated from the town funds so kids in Middlesex would receive the same discount that the Waterbury kids receive.
Okay, so that would be, so do they need 10 kids?
They don't need 10 kids, but it's up to 250. Maybe make a motion of up to 250.
Okay. Anyone have any discussion about that?
I do, I'm not on the select board, yes. But I do. Rumney itself runs a winter wellness program. Mm-hmm. Right after the holidays, I think it starts. And it either runs, it was 6 weeks, they might have cut it back to 4 weeks. Mm-hmm. But if one of the options is for swimming for kids.
Right.
So
not lessons, but just playing in the pool.
Not lessons, but yep. Just in the pool or something like that. I don't know when this program takes place, if it's like weekends or nights or when it is. But there is that program that the school is already, and the kids have the option of skating, swimming, or skiing, I believe.
They did that when my kids were there. They had a ski program. I didn't know.
Yeah. Right.
Well, I think just given the fact that swimming is a valuable lesson, a valuable tool for people to have the skill of swimming, that if we, were able to get some kids so that it could happen, I'm certainly for that. Because I think, too, we might actually possibly get a better turnout in the winter than in the summer, just based on people's busy schedules and things like that. Just give somebody, So anyway, I don't have any problems with it. Anyone else? Thoughts on that?
Is that for this winter?
Yeah, I think it so. Is. Yeah. Steve, any thoughts?
I'm fine with it.
Okay. Anyone want to make a motion?
Some.
Up to 200.
Up to the 250.
Yeah.
25.
So that'd be 10 kids, I guess. Yeah. And did someone second that?
Second.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
What happens if you have more than 25 kids? That
more than 10.
I don't know. They probably won't take more than
they can't go beyond 10.
They can't accommodate more than 10.
So probably first 10.
Okay, so I haven't looked at the orders yet. So I will look at those. And yeah, okay. Cool. And do you actually know, Dorinda, how much is left in the fund for the what's next, Middlesex?
I don't. Okay. Actually, it's written on a separate order, so okay. I think you can figure it out very easily.
Because okay. we had the Vermont Community Fund loan and the WEC loan.
Right, and then you have
a WEC grant.
Outside donation of, was that 500?
I think it was
500.
Okay, so I didn't know about that. Yeah. I thought that went to I don't know. The food shelf and the local foods fundraiser, but it was given to this fund.
It was designated for this fund.
So my guess is there's almost $1,000 there left.
Yeah,
maybe
I didn't.
700.
She didn't leave until 6:30 last night.
All right, so you're telling me that this is what's
That's
been
what
spent.
We dispersed today.
Okay. All right, so and then I just don't remember what the original community loan fund grant was. It was like a uneven dollar amount, but I can look at that.
Yeah,
it was like 2,000 something. Okay, cool. All right, correspondence. Oh, reaction to junk ordinance letter. So did someone respond to that?
Yeah, Tammy Horan was not happy.
Okay.
She sent an email complaining about the fact that the letter that I sent on behalf of the board, the first letter had been delayed. It hadn't been sent right away. And I tried to explain to her that that was because the person making the complaint had some worries that she would get the letter, be mad, and then do nothing. And in fact, she got the letter, she's mad, and she's not going to do anything.
Okay.
So I followed up by calling Boulder, and it turns out that they have a guy from Barrie. Mm-hmm. Who will call you up and say, I'll give you this much for your cars, and I'll pick them up and drag them to Boulder's. He does it two or three times a day.
Yeah.
I called someone just the other month for that.
Did you?
Yeah.
So I sent that to her, and I have not heard anything less. Okay. And Peter did sign that letter, so it's not just for me.
So what is our next plan of action?
Well, you're the select board.
I know. but what does it say? The ordinance is that after
30 days, if they don't do anything, you can fine them. I think it's something like up to $50 a day for not complying with the ordinance.
Okay.
So the letter was mailed out November 15th or something like that. So you have some time. It'll be something to address at the next meeting. But I thought that I would let you guys know in case Tammy calls or gives you an earful.
Yeah.
So you said the letter went out the 15th?
Right.
Okay. So then we should have it on the next agenda, because we want to follow through with this.
Right.
If we're sending out the letters, we have,
to follow through.
We have to follow through. So.
Where's the property?
Daniel's Farm Road.
Okay. Any other business that may come before the board? You wanted to mention something?
Yeah, I wanted to discuss the Kellogg Hubbard Library special article petition. So right now the select board requires a petition. As for the other special articles, and Tom McCone, who's the executive director of the library, asked me to bring this up. The other member towns, the other contributor towns to Kellogg Hubbard Library don't require this, except Worcester. We in Worcester are the only one. So the request is that the select board put that article on the town warning without requiring a petition.
Without requiring a petition?
It requires an extra layer of work for libraries.
So it's something that we as a select board would decide to put on, or no? What
yeah,
do you mean?
Similar to the way you put the conservation $5,000 on.
It'd have
right.
to be in your budget.
It's like us, yeah, that we're doing, yeah. I don't.
It's an extra layer of work for them. Most of the other towns in the city don't require.
Well,
I'm not comfortable putting that in the budget.
It's something
like
you can't do actionable right now. So.
Right,
yeah.
I realize
yeah.
that. You have to do it at your next meeting.
Yeah.
It would still be a special article with all the others.
But.
Right, but it doesn't. No. Oh, you're saying it's a special article.
You just don't require.
It's just not required signatures, so it's not in the budget.
There's
only one right now that the select board does, and that's the
conservation
yeah.
fund.
Right. And so Peter feels very strongly about this, and Mary, I know, feels very strongly about this. There's nothing you can do, but you can put it when you can bring it to, we can put it on the agenda for the 18th.
Sure. And what? How do they feel about it?
Their argument has been that people should work for it.
Yeah,
you should get the backing of the voters on the
okay.
petitions first. I mean, they're on. We get receive an awful lot of petitions. How much is the Kellogg Hubbard Library asking for this year? Do you know?
Same as last
yeah.
year. I have to look in the town report to tell you what it is.
Why is the Conservation Commission treated differently?
I don't know. You'd have to have Peter. Those guys with that statute for the.
Well, it's, I would think because they're a town
yeah,
entity and
yeah.
not an outside entity.
The logic for the library would be it's the closest thing to a town entity
yeah.
of
yeah.
all of these special articles.
Yeah. Okay. Do you guys want that to go on an agenda? I mean,
mm-hmm.
yeah, I think so. Okay.
When do petitions
right. Any other business that may come before the board? No?
Well, let's see. It does seem like there was one other thing, but I can't remember what it was.
We had a bat here. Yes.
A bat.
Oh, did you get any calls on the cluster fly cleanup?
I actually, as a matter of fact, Susan Rickstad is the only one who responded. She lives right next door. She used to have a cleaning business.
Well,
so
there you go.
She looked pretty good.
Yeah. George asked a question.
What's the deadline? Petitions.
I just have
this doesn't pass.
It's all on the town website. I have all the forms. I'm trying to keep the deadline for the petition versus the deadline for nominations are two different deadlines. One's
right.
January 28th and one's January 17th. I think the petitioned articles are January 17th. And the to run again or to run for a board is January 28th. So but also, that is all on our website. You can; those are petitions that have downloaded. I've had those there since July.
It did occur to me, just due to this power outage that we had too, that that I think can I get a copy of that emergency, like the latest emergency management, with like some of the people that may need to get contacted
mm-hmm.
that are on our
yep.
emergency list.
I think I've got it PDF'd.
Yeah, if you could send that, because I
is
I
that
think
on the website too? No.
I don't know.
The names of the people like to
yeah
contact
the
when there's
list.
A power outage or something like that.
I can send it to you. It's right.
We have
file.
The vulnerable
yeah.
population.
Yeah.
Is what's his name? Paul Attenti. He's not living in Middlesex right now.
No,
is he?
They actually just
digging the foundation right
yeah,
now.
Okay. So he's not necessarily attuned to what is actually happening in our town.
Well, he was here last week.
I don't know about that.
Okay.
I'd say he's very attuned to what's
okay.
happening
yeah, no,
in
he
the
was,
town.
He's, no, I just meant like with the like he knows that there's a power outage going on.
Yeah.
He's
oh, yeah.
familiar.
Yes.
He was here during
yes.
that.
All right.
He's on top of it more than we are.
Oh, good. All right.
He's here a lot for not living in town.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
all the
That's
time.
Good.
All the time.
All right. Is that it?
Did you get from Jeremy Hansen the Central Vermont Internet report for the Broward Town reports?
I might have.
Okay, I'll check with you later.
But
on.
That's
so
a good thing to put into the town report. Thank you for reminding
yeah.
me. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. By law, we have to.
Oh, you do.
The chair has to send that out. If you don't, if you didn't, or you didn't get it, I certainly have a copy and I can give it to you.
Okay, I'm sure it's. We're just compiling everything now.
Yeah.
We're kind of ahead of the game, actually. All right. Anything else? Alrighty.
We're adjourning the meeting at 5:57. Thank you.